General, I've arrived at Ord Mantell.
Perfect timing. I've just finished coordinating things with my man on the ground there. SIS agent Atau followed the enemy transmissions to a specific location planetside. He'll give you the full details. Your T-7 unit can interface with Darth Angrel's hyperspace data transceiver and download his communications. Take the droid with you.
Guess I'll be playing Dejarik against myself while you have all the fun.
I'm ready to go, General.
Take a shuttle to the surface and meet Agent Atau. Good hunting. Varsuthra out.
I've visited my share of seedy ports, but this one's the seediest. Just as well I'm staying behind. I'll make sure nobody steals our landing thrusters.
Check out the spaceport while we're gone. If this place is as bad as you say, Darth Angrel may have a presence here.
Wouldn't surprise me. I'll poke around and see what's what. Have fun down there.
Agent Otao, Republic SIS. Welcome to Ord Mantell. Hope you enjoy war zones, Master Jedi. This planet's full of them.
What's this all about?
Long story short, there's a civil war between Republic loyalists and a separatist movement bent on Ord Mantell's independence. That's the official story. The unofficial one is that the separatists are funded and supplied by the Empire.
Sounds like things are headed in a dark direction.
Only reason we're not fighting the Empire now is because they won't commit their own forces. They'd rather throw separatists at us. General Varsuthra had me send a probe droid to the hyperspace data transceiver's location. I learned two things. First, it's on an island. Second, they don't like visitors there. My probe droid wound up disintegrated. Make sure that doesn't happen to you, eh?
Disintegration isn't on my to-do list.
When you find the hyperspace data transceiver, plug in your T-7 unit and download everything you can from its logs. With any luck, we'll learn what Darth Angrel's been up to. Be seeing you.
Name, Markovic. Rank, Lieutenant. That's all you're getting from me, Jedi scum.
I'm not here for you anyway.
Hey, what's that droid doing? Get away from there!
Copy every file you can, T-7. We need to know what this desolator weapon can do.
You won't live long enough to tell anyone!
Get the rest of Darth Angrel's design files for the desolator weapon.
Back already? That was quick.
T-7 downloaded some of Angrel's communication logs, but the rest were destroyed.
Some intel is better than none. At least the Empire has one less hidey hole. I'll put together a team, see if we can secure that island for our side. You should report to General Varsuthra. Be seeing you.
So your master was here all along. Well played, Padawan. Your lies convinced even Darth Angrel.
Put down that lightsaber and step away from my Padawan.
Spare me your pathetic demands. I hold the power here, not you. Imperial intelligence noticed this girl wandering the station and alerted my master. Darth Angrel came from 20 parsecs away for a personal interrogation. Unfortunately, we were led to believe you weren't here.
Told them you were on Corellia. Suckers.
No matter. We have you now. Surrender. Unless you want your Padawan to die.
He's lying. He can't kill me. Angrel's orders.
Release my Padawan. It's your only way out of this.
I'll never understand what drives you Jedi to throw away your lives. You risk certain death to free this girl. Why? Some misguided sense of duty.
I care a great deal about my Padawan, and I'll punish anyone who threatens her.
My, aren't you the interesting one? Pity you have to die. When I present Darth Angrel with your head, he'll be most appreciative.
Don't take this the wrong way, but I've never been happier to see anyone my whole life. It was the least I could do. I promise this won't happen again. Getting rescued is bad for my self-confidence. Angrel wanted to know everything about you. Threatened to kill me if I didn't answer all his questions. I'm sorry if he hurt you. Don't apologize. I knew what I was signing on for when we left Coruscant. Angrel left with an Imperial Admiral to refit a battlecruiser. Sounds like they have some new weapon. Desolator? We should warn the General about this right away.
Looks like Tarnas was combining all your weapon projects to create something codenamed Desolator. We believe Angrel's arming his battlecruiser with it.
And it's no coincidence I've lost contact with Agent Galen. The enemy is raiding our weapon research facilities to build that device.
What about Master Orgus and Quix? Have they checked in?
They went on comm silence after leaving Coruscant. They're due to check in soon. We can't let Darth Angrel complete this Desolator weapon, whatever it is. I need your help stopping him. Securing Nar Shaddaa is vital, but there's another target just as important on Terrace.
You have another super weapon on Terrace you didn't tell us about?
I'd rather not say more until you're there.
How can I make an informed choice without information?
Too many security breaches here. I won't risk the enemy finding out about this. When you reach Terrace or Nar Shaddaa, contact me. And good luck.
General, I'm on Terrace. You seemed worried about this place after Ord Mantell. What's the big mystery you wouldn't reveal?
I apologize for the secrecy, but this involves someone the Empire would love to get its hands on. Angrel's son, Tarnas, was the lead scientist on our advanced warfare projects. But these technologies were all invented by Dr. Nassan Godera. Dr. Godera's a genius. Calculates targeting algorithms in his head for fun.
If he's so special, why wasn't he leading things instead of Tarnas?
Dr. Godera hates the Empire. So much so he quit in protest when the Republic signed the Treaty of Coruscant. Disappeared completely. We recently discovered he's hiding on Terrace, but the swamps, predators, and city ruins are keeping us from finding him.
How could he survive in such a place?
He's a resourceful man, and he isn't alone. He brought advanced droids with him. The Republic is recolonizing Terrace. Recently, we found evidence that our missing doctor has been here for years. Reconnaissance discovered one of Godera's outposts in the swamp. It's entirely automated. Nothing but droids inside. And they're not cooperating.
If the doctor isn't there, what do the droids at this outpost do?
We think Godera has several facilities. The droids are caretakers in his absence. I've had people scouring Terrace for other outposts. The survivors returned empty-handed. After what you learned on Ord Mantell, we need that man's expertise. You're our best shot at finding Dr. Godera.
I'll bring him back alive, whatever it takes.
I left a small team monitoring the outpost. They'll aid your search. Transmitting outpost coordinates. Good luck. Marsuthra, out.
That's enough bloodshed. Let's be professional about this. I am Watcher One with Imperial Intelligence. Those men you fought served me.
What kind of name is that?
My title is who I am. Any other name I gave you would be a lie. Despite what General Varsuthra believes, I have known about this outpost for some time. Your imminent arrival forced me to take action. My mission is to protect the Empire from Dr. Godera's weapons. I'm afraid I can't let you have him.
There's nothing you can do to stop me.
Imperial Intelligence prides itself on accurate threat assessment. I've known you were coming, analyzed your strengths and weaknesses in preparation. You defeated the fallen Jedi, Bengal Moore, to become a knight. You're an exemplar of your order.
Either this guy reads minds, or he's got spies on Tython.
He's trying to get under our skin, make us paranoid.
Your mental state is immaterial to the situation. As fortune would have it, Dr. Godera will be in my custody shortly. You've already failed.
The Force is with me. I'll find Dr. Godera. And you.
I see my reinforcements are finally in position. Terminator.
Blasted imps. Death is too good for them. Thank you for liberating this facility. Good riddance to imp scum.
Are you one of Dr. Godera's droids? What happened here?
My designation is REM0. Dr. Godera assigned me to this facility. Primary function? Enemy surveillance. The facility was compromised when Republic cowards arrived on Terrace, and again by these imp scum.
Why do you call the Republic cowards? These people died defending you.
Republic cowards surrendered to the Empire many years ago. These deaths do not alter that fact. My programming forbids cooperation with non-Godera lifeforms, except under extreme circumstances. That criteria is now met. Watcher 1 reprogrammed this facility's tracking relays. He traced Dr. Godera's encrypted bioscan to its present location.
If it worked for Watcher 1, it'll work for us.
The imp scum destroyed the central computer, hoping to prevent this. I must repair it while you reset the outdoor tracking relays. I will provide you with the tracking relay's coordinates, but be advised, the outdoors are dangerous.
You fix the computer, and I'll reset the tracking relays.
Jedi were never included in Dr. Godera's Republic Coward designation. Now I comprehend why. Commencing computer repairs. Contact me when all tracking relays are reset. Then we can triangulate Dr. Godera's location. If you encounter any imp scum, please annihilate them. How you handle Republic cowards is your discretion. Good luck, Jedi.
I finished resetting all the tracking relays. Is that central computer online?
Affirmative. Triangulating Dr. Godera's coordinates now. This facility has outlived its usefulness, and my programming provides no secondary mission. I am uncertain how to proceed. Serving Republic cowards is unacceptable, but I am not armed to combat imp scum. Recommendation?
Dr. Godera needs all the help he can get. You should come.
Excellent suggestion. Perhaps I can acquire new mission parameters from my maker. Triangulation complete. Transmitting the coordinates to you now. I am coming, but do not wait for me. My maker needs you, Jedi.
Chunki salamanatupa. Jiholokto chobot I kafsto andale.
How do you know Dr. Godera?
Vathopa jiwanta humpa mulira bampa wula. Konkipona hukta tabatata. Sigunra deha yaliska chanaga. Itinka chasa hopoma.
Keep out of sight and protect your friend.
Niju wata klonki.
Stand down, Jedi. I'm afraid we both lose this contest. Dr. Godera killed himself rather than be captured. It's a tragic loss.
Your goal was to kill him.
He was far more valuable to us alive. We are prepared to leave Terrace without further violence. Full cessation of hostilities. Do you accept?
You've committed crimes against the Republic. I'm taking you in.
You know I can't allow that. Be reasonable. Unlike the men at the outpost, we're trained to fight Jedi. Don't underestimate us.
Wait, Jedi. These filthy imps are lying to you. My maker is not dead. I arrived late because I performed a second triangulation on my maker's bioscan.
Thought we destroyed that irritating machine. Now you both have to die.
Critical damage. Circuits failing. Transmitting my maker's new coordinates to you now. Save him. Do not let my functions end in vain.
Your main processor and memory circuits are intact. If there's a way to repair you, I'll find it.
Filthy imps! Kill them all!
Not my finest performance, but serviceable. Do not fear. Dr. Godera is unharmed. I painlessly rendered him unconscious and gently carried him to safety.
That trick only works once. Next time, I'll be ready.
There doesn't need to be a next time. We could continue this chase forever, but what a waste of resources. I suggest a compromise. Give me time to administer truth serum to Dr. Gadara. Once he reveals his secrets, he's yours. We'll both have what we want.
You've already deceived me twice. I'd be a fool to give you another chance.
My deceptions have failed to produce the desired result. Now, I'm telling the truth. I will purchase time for interrogating Dr. Gadara by offering you something of great personal interest. A Sith assassin is on Taris preparing to massacre a small Republic settlement. I can tell you where.
Why are you so readily sharing this with me?
The information Dr. Gadara possesses is worth more than terrorizing defenseless colonists. I know you won't risk innocent lives. It's not in your nature.
We have to help those people.
Rescue your settlement. When that's done, come here and you'll receive Dr. Gadara unharmed. You have my word.
Betray me and you'll regret it.
The Republic colonists have a temporary shelter near some ruins. Sending the coordinates now. The Sith assassin is noted for being a master of beasts. She likely won't be alone. I advise caution. Good luck, Jedi.
Welcome, Master Jedi. How did our humble settlement earn this honor? Do you need food or water? Anything we have is yours.
A Sith wants you all dead. I'm here to defend you.
Sith? But why us? We haven't done anything.
Since when do Sith need a reason to kill people?
This is horrible. We're not prepared for this.
Then you should not have come back to a world that is not yours. Taris belongs to the Sith Empire, now and forever. Even my beasts understand that.
I can sense the fear in your animals.
They're only afraid of me. You just make them hungry. Before you die, satisfy my curiosity. My mission was secret. How did you know about it?
One of your top spies warned me you were coming.
I'll inform Darth Angrel of this security breach, but first things first. My pets are ready to play. Are you?
I haven't encountered a creature yet that could stop me.
You should feel honored to die at my hand.
That Sith and her beasts! If you hadn't been here, they'd have torn us to pieces. Our settlement is new. We have fresh supplies. Please, take some.
Your safety is all the reward I need.
My parents told me stories of the Jedi when I was a boy. Now I know they're true.
Glad we did this, but we need to wipe that smug grin off Watcher One's face, shall we?
Lord Angrel, my interrogation is complete. Transmitting my report to you now.
Your efficiency will be noted. Take Dr. Gadara to Droman Kaas. I have plans for him.
You never mentioned you were working for Angrel.
What is this? Explain yourself, Watcher.
To ensure mission success, I compromised with the Jedi. She's here for the Doctor.
You compromised with the Jedi vermin who killed my son. Perhaps I should be grateful. You spared me the effort of hunting you down.
Stop throwing your lackeys at me. If you want to end this, do it in person.
Watcher, bring me this filth alive. I will kill her myself.
Respectfully, my lord. I'm duty-bound to honor our bargain.
Don't trifle with me. I want that Jedi.
Very well, Lord Angrel. I apologize for reneging on our deal, but I have orders. You understand. I recommend you surrender.
Give me Dr. Gadara. Walk away while you still can.
We seem to be at an impasse. This is not the ending I would have chosen. Again, Darth Angrel underestimates you. 20 years, I've avoided becoming a casualty of Sith madness. but an order is an order.
I wish these events could have ended better.
I served the Empire as best I could. I have no regrets. Regardless, you are the victor here. How do you wish to proceed?
Engra will kill you for failing. You can't return to the Empire. Go. Find a new life in the Republic. You may discover we're not the enemy you think.
What? Only a fool would question such a generous offer. I thank you. Perhaps our paths will cross again. Farewell, Jedi.
Dr. Gudera, are you all right? I'm a Jedi Knight sent by General Varsuthra to rescue you.
Varsuthra? That old man never gives up, does he? The Imperials gave me a Class 4 truth serum. Don't remember the interrogation, but I fear they learned too much. I suppose you plan to take me back to Coruscant? I left for good reason, you know.
We need you, Doctor. The Republic is endangered.
It's been endangered since that idiotic treaty. The Sith Empire only sought a strategic pause in the fighting. Time to gather strength for a final crushing blow. The Senate ignored my projections. I refuse to serve such monumental ignorance.
The Republic needed time to regain strength too. So did the Jedi.
And are we ready to finish this war? Or will we sit back while the Empire devours the galaxy? If it hasn't started already, all-out war is imminent. I'm ready to face what's coming. Perhaps it is time I returned. Finish the war, and wipe out the Empire for good.
I told you, Agent. This Jedi never fails.
My team came to assist you. We discovered the outpost was destroyed and assumed the worst. Can you tell us what happened? We have unconfirmed reports the Imperial Spymaster Watcher 1 is on Terrace.
The Spymaster was working for Darth Angrel. I dealt with Watcher 1, but the Empire knows too much about us.
The Empire's spy network will suffer without Watcher 1's guidance. That buys us time.
Dr. Gudera, you're looking well, all things considered. Ready to come home?
Depends. Are you ready to do what's right?
I always was, and our time has finally come. Agent, bring Dr. Gudera to Coruscant immediately. You'll be needing his skills. Contact me from your ship. Varsuthra out.
Then this is goodbye. You saved my life. I owe you.
I'd never have found you without your droid. The Imperials destroyed it, but I salvaged the memory core.
Ah, Remo. One of my favorites. Thank you for salvaging his parts. Yes, I look forward to putting him back together.
That droid's a hero. He deserves a second chance.
Working on Remo will make the long flight to Coruscant more bearable. Goodbye for now. I'm sure we'll see each other again.
General, Dr. Gudera's on his way to you.
I can only imagine what the Empire would have done with him if you hadn't been there. I'm also told you saved a Republic settlement from a Sith assassin. Those colonists were lucky you showed up. How did you wind up there anyway?
The Imperial Spymaster warned me what the Sith was planning.
Division in the enemy ranks? Interesting. Let's hope there's more to come. Your work here may be done, but this isn't over.
General, I've arrived on Nar Shaddaa. Still no word from Agent Galen?
Negative. After Terrace and Ord Mantell, I fear the worst. I'll warn you now. The project there is... I should have ended it years ago.
Conversations like this never end well.
After the Empire's victory on Coruscant during the war, people were terrified. We looked weak, helpless. The Senate authorized research into science we had no business exploring, using technology to turn ordinary men into living weapons. The Power Guard program was creating the ultimate soldier, one tough enough to fight a Sith head-on.
The best defense against a Sith is someone like me.
Your order was nearly extinct. The Senate feared you might never recover. Nar Shaddaa has the latest advances in cybernetics, combat adrenals, personal armor and weapons. Everything we need to create the Power Guards. There's also a distinct lack of government oversight. You're in hot territory, neutral space. Laws are practically non-existent.
It's my first visit to Hutt space. What do you know about them?
Hutts break laws just breathing, but they let us do our business, no questions asked. I placed a single operative in charge of the Power Guard project. Gave him unlimited authority and enough credits to fund the program. The research facility operates in absolute secrecy. I don't even know where it is.
Darth Angrel's henchmen on Coruscant said all our research facilities were compromised.
Our operative's name and contact data were in the file stolen on Coruscant. Our operative has disappeared, and Agent Galen vanished trying to find him. I can only assume they're dead or captured.
If they're alive, I'll save them. But what about the weapons project?
Our research can die for all I care. I need you to coordinate with the Strategic Information Service branch on Nar Shaddaa. The Bureau Chief's name is Raikin. SIS headquarters is hidden on the promenade. You'll visit a merchant shop and use a secret turbo lift in the back to meet with Raikin.
Promenade, shop, secret turbo lift. Got it. I feel like a spy already.
Transmitting the location coordinates and turbo lift security code to you. Good luck. Varsuthra, out.
That's the second field agent who's missed a check-in. Our network's under attack.
We don't know that.
We know Agent Galen was captured. He's telling the enemy where to hit us.
If it makes you feel better, transmit alert level Omega to all field agents. See how many respond. The Jedi who eliminated Watcher 1. Glad to meet you. I'm Bureau Chief Raikin. Wish I had better news to report. We're fumbling in the dark right now.
Lighting up the darkness is one of my specialties.
Here's what little I know. Agent Galen came here to secure a top-secret operation. Something hidden even from us. Galen disappeared in the Nikto sector while pursuing a contact. Fortunately, he left a trail we can follow.
What do you know about the person Galen was after?
The General said it was the operative in charge of his project. More than that, I don't know. Galen left coded progress reports at SIS dead drops all over the Nikto sector. Unfortunately, that whole area's gone hostile. Had to pull my agents out. You want those reports? You'll have to go in alone.
Thank goodness. For a second, I thought this might be too easy.
I sent the Omega alert. Only half our field agents responded. I'm telling you, we're compromised. We need to move this headquarters before it's too late.
Darth Angrel is clearly targeting the SIS. Time to move.
We'll wipe the computers and leave Nar Shaddaa.
Evacuating this facility is out of the question. We're safe here, and we have a mission to complete. I've marked the locations of Agent Galen's dead drops. Download his messages to your holo and contact me. I'll decode them. Let's get some answers. Good luck.
Chief Raikin, I've downloaded all of Agent Galen's coded messages.
Transmitting a decryption signal to your holo. Descrambling? Times and locations, standard tracking details. And one priority holo. Playing that back now.
Found our lead operative. Dead. He'd been tortured. The Power Guard data files are missing. No clues to the main facility's location, but there was evidence of a recruitment center here. The project was using refugees as test subjects. The recruitment center's my best shot at finding the main facility. I'm going in. Leaving the site's coordinates just in case. Galen out.
Took guts going in there alone.
Not sure what's worse. The enemy stealing our weapons project, or us experimenting on refugees.
I'm shocked General Varsuthra permitted illegal testing.
With all the layers of secrecy, he probably didn't know. Agent Galen, or whoever got him, holds the key to recovering the Power Guard project. The trail ends at that recruitment center. You need to get inside there, find out what's happened. Good luck. Raikin out.
You'll be all right. I'm here to help. Chief Raikin, the recruitment center was overrun with Imperials. No sign of Agent Galen, but I've just freed some refugees.
Not refugees. Heroes. These people put their lives on the line for victory over the Empire. Name's Velnarok. Been recruiting volunteers for the Power Guard project since it started.
Those people asked to become test subjects?
The Empire stole their homeworlds. They jumped at the chance for payback. Over the years, hundreds of people volunteered for the Power Guard experiments. Heroes. All of them.
Tell me what happened here.
I was organizing fresh recruits when Imperials stormed inside. They rounded us up. Threw us in the cage. Don't know how the Empire found us. But they control the whole project now.
Tell me where the Power Guard experiments take place.
Never seen the main lab, but it's someplace in the Red Light Sector. Imperials are sending people there for testing.
That's one of the busiest parts of Nar Shaddaa. We'll never find the lab.
I've heard it's the only building with a dedicated energy reactor. Does that help?
Absolutely. Contact me when you're in the Red Light Sector. I'll have a plan. Riken out.
I'll get these volunteers to safety. I hope you kill every last one of those Imperials.
I'm in the Red Light Sector. You have a plan for finding that main lab?
If the Power Guard facility has a dedicated reactor, it's immune to energy fluctuations affecting the power grid. My team is monitoring energy readings in that sector. All you have to do is cause some fluctuations. Applying a lightsaber to the right power conduits ought to do the trick.
If I disrupt power to an entire city sector, innocent people might be injured.
Trust me, no one there is innocent. Regardless, the fluctuations will be short-lived and harmless. Send in coordinates to key power conduits. Hit them all, and we'll get a fix on that Power Guard main lab. And be careful. The Red Light Sector may look civilized, but it's nothing of the sort. Riken out. Only one building in the sector maintained a steady energy supply when you disrupted those power conduits. That has to be the main lab. Send in coordinates now. Aside from Agent Galen and the test subjects, we have no idea what you'll face in there. How will you play this?
Whatever surprises the enemy has in store, a Jedi is always ready.
With luck, you'll catch the opposition off guard. You're in for a hell of a fight.
Here goes nothing.
Contact me when it's done. Riken out.
We've been waiting for you, Jedi. Darth Angrel told me you defeated Watcher One and Inquisitor Farav. Impressive.
Explains why you're not here. Scared, huh? You soldiers, lay down your weapons. I promise you'll be treated fairly. More than you deserve.
You killed good men at that recruitment center. Loyal soldiers, the best.
They served evil. The galaxy won't miss them.
No one will miss you, either.
I promised Commander Grawl he could execute you personally. And I left him a few gifts to help. Mark One Power Guards, not as destructive as the later models I possess, but quick to assemble and quite malleable. It took nothing to wipe their useless minds and program them to serve me.
You captured a Republic agent. What have you done with him?
Something extraordinary. But you won't live to see it. Kill the Jedi, cut out the Padawan's tongue, and bring it to me.
We're too late, Riken. Darth Angrel's apprentice raided the lab. There's nothing left here. I found an encrypted data pad on an Imperial officer. It looks important.
It may have information on where the enemy's moved to. Bring the data pad back to headquarters. My slicers will crack the decryption. We'll have to move fast to stop the enemy. Hurry.
I warned him. I told Riken this base was compromised.
The Chief's dead. They're all dead. What were those things?
They're like what I fought at the main lab, but more powerful.
You kept us out of the loop, hid the Power Guard facility, never told us about these weapons. We stayed, supported your mission when we should have evacuated. These deaths are on you.
If you want to yell at someone, call Varsuthra. He authorized the project.
Everyone responsible for this should be brought up on charges. With Raikin dead, I'm acting bureau chief. This operation's over. Agent Diaz, we're leaving now. Sorry, friend, but you're on your own.
Chief Raikin promised to unlock these Imperial files.
Then take it up with him. His body's over there.
Wait a minute, this Jedi is the only person who can stop those things.
I gave you an order, Agent.
And I lost my hearing during the fight. Give me the data pad. I'll do my best. Decryption complete. The enemy took everything from the Power Guard lab to a fallback position. I recognize these coordinates. An Imperial-controlled factory on the industrial level.
I couldn't have done this without your help.
Make those scum pay for what they did to us.
You have your information. The rest is up to you.
I'm sorry for keeping you here. Find someplace to hide until this is over.
Sir, I recommend we inform General Var Suthra. We need immediate reinforcements. I've marked the enemy's fallback position. Good luck down there.
Let's go, Agent Diaz.
You shouldn't have come. You'll make me hurt you. He already forced me to give up my fellow agents. Now they're all dead.
Agent Galen, what happened to you?
When I resist the pain, he always wins.
I'll break his control over you. I promise.
Too late. He's here.
Nothing more irritating than a Jedi who won't die. Your constant interruptions must end. Your former ally will be your executioner. The new Agent Galen's power is matched only by his obedience.
Face me yourself, or are you scared you'll wind up like Tarnas?
Tarnas was a child, like you, beneath me. Galen, destroy my enemy.
No, I'd rather die.
Control Factor 6 initiated. Neural override complete. Launching elimination protocol. Target? Jedi.
I told you. He always wins. Stop! I'm in control. All that damage you did finally spread to the neural overrides. Only temporary, though. I can already feel my systems repairing themselves.
Will you attack me again?
I'll keep trying to fulfill my last command until I succeed. But we have bigger problems. The Sith Lord, Lord Static, has the Republic's Mark III Power Guards, cybernetically enhanced soldiers armed with advanced weapons. Static plans to build hundreds more, all controlled by him, an army to conquer Nar Shaddaa.
The Sith could make thousands, millions of Power Guards.
Static's building his army in Shadowtown, an Imperial-controlled sector. Nastiest people on Nar Shaddaa. And that's saying a lot. I'll give you the coordinates. Ah! Neural override restarted. There's nothing else to do. Kill me!
There must be a way to free you. Give me time to defeat Static.
Free me? From this? Even without Static controlling me, I won't live like this.
Hold on, Galen. We need to face Static together. We're the only people who can bring him to justice for what he's done. Are you with me?
Don't know how long I can resist his commands, but I'll try. Safer if we don't travel together, just in case. I'll meet you inside Static's base in Shadowtown. Hurry. We don't have much time.
You're strong to have made it this far, but not strong enough. I am more than Sith now. Much more.
He's tall. I'll give him that.
Remarkable technology. So versatile. I just calculated 17 different ways to end your life.
All that hardware won't save you from me.
I've run the numbers. You overestimate your chances. A shame you'll never understand what true power feels like. Perhaps I'll add you to my army after all. Darth Angrel would appreciate that.
No. We'll kill you first.
Agent Galen, still functional? Let me rectify that. Control Factor 10 initiated. Obey me! or I'll tear your mind apart.
You're in control, Galen, not him. He has no power over you.
I have all the power. I am power. Not anymore. Never again. I'm with you, Jedi. Let's finish this.
Don't look so surprised. It's our job to follow people. Agent Diaz planted a tracker on you back at headquarters.
Standard operating procedure. No offense intended.
Would have been here sooner, but getting into Imperial territory without a lightsaber is complicated.
Glad I don't have to hold the space by myself.
We won't be staying long. This is Black Star Squad, a special operations team. General Varsuthra pulled in a favor with General Garza. Got him here quick. We're demolishing this location. Make sure the enemy can't recover anything useful.
Good. I'll stay and die with this place.
Galen? You've changed.
I'm dangerous. I should be destroyed.
Inside, you're the same man you've always been. A hero.
The SIS looks after its own, Galen. We'll help you.
Just get me out of here.
Lieutenant, prep this man for extraction.
Sir, I've located the Power Guard files, including notes on how the Sith controlled them. Orders?
That technology is too horrible to exist. Erase the data.
I disagree, but I'm ready to be done with this. Go ahead, Agent Diaz. You should check in with General Varsuthra. We'll be right behind you. Just need to plant the incendiary charges. It was interesting working with you. Good luck.
We narrowly escaped a major disaster, General. But a lot of good people died.
Chief Raikin and his agents are a terrible loss. What happened to Galen? Well, at least he's alive. Just heard from Special Agent Tander. His team eradicated all trace of what happened at that Sith base. Thank you for destroying the Power Guard files. Approving that project was the biggest mistake of my career.
Never let fear compromise your ideals.
If only it were that simple. The Republic's position on Nar Shaddaa is precarious at best. Better for everyone if this operation remains classified. I'm sealing all records of what happened here. You, me, and the SIS are the only ones who know the full story.
Keeping secrets got people killed. The reason they died can't stay hidden.
I'll file a full report with my superiors. I hope they don't drum me out of the service. I know you're probably exhausted, but the enemy hasn't given up. Neither can we. A major tactical advantage has just opened up, but you have to act quickly. One of Darth Angrel's closest advisors, Admiral Hacklin, asked us for asylum. He wants to defect.
Hacklin was with Angrel when he interrogated me on Ord Mantell. They seemed chummy. What changed?
I'm not sure, but the Admiral is on the run. There are unconfirmed reports Hacklin's earned a death mark.
One of Darth Angrel's top men turned traitor? It's too convenient. Exactly. This is obviously a trap.
Hacklin wouldn't be the first high-ranking Imperial to switch sides. Until we know otherwise, we have to believe this is real. Kira obviously made an impression on the Admiral at Ord Mantell. He says he'll only surrender to her.
I have a bad feeling about this.
There's no time to negotiate. Admiral Hacklin's expecting you to, and no one else. I told him to wait for you at an old asteroid mining facility. I'm uploading the coordinates now.
What can you tell me about this place?
The mining facility is abandoned and well off standard hyperspace routes. It's the safest place we could find for the Admiral. Be careful out there.
Greetings. I am Valis. Your quick response is most appreciated. Please forgive the deception. Admiral Hacklin remains Darth Angrel's faithful servant. His name simply made this meeting convenient.
He's a Sith! Kill him!
Now, really, is that any way to treat your family?
Family? Kira, you know this man?
Don't listen to him. He's trying to confuse you. Us.
Your Padawan isn't who you think. She's no Jedi. She's a child of the Emperor. Like me. And it's time she returned to our father's warm embrace.
I've never heard of any Emperor's children. Who are you people?
The Chosen Ones, selected at birth to serve our father's great glory. a distinction we should wear with pride. Don't deny your true lineage.
I'm not a Sith. Don't let him turn you against me. We can defeat him. Together.
We have no quarrel, Jedi. Return to your ship and let Kira come home. The Emperor wills it.
It doesn't matter where she came from. She's my Padawan.
Tell our father not to expect any calls or letters.
There's no escaping your destiny, Kira. Thanks to your little brush with Darth Angril, the Emperor knows you're alive and where to find you. No matter where you go, Father sees you. He sees you right now. And he wants you back.
I'd rather die than see him again.
So be it, sister.
Thanks for sticking by me. I know this was a big shock, but I can explain. My parents were Sith, but the Emperor isn't my father. Child of the Emperor is just a title. I was taken from my parents when I was a baby. Raised in the Sith Academy with others like Valis. It was brutal.
I can only imagine the pain you must have endured.
Pain became normal. There were worse things. Every so often, the other children were taken to see our father. They came back different. Nobody ever remembered meeting the Emperor. One day, I realized I couldn't remember anything from the past week. They were doing the same thing to me.
Whatever the Sith did, it's buried in your memories. We have to uncover it.
I've tried. Every time I get close to the memory, it changes. Slithers away. I was still a child then. Small enough to stow away on a supply ship leaving Imperial space. Lived in lots of bad places until I met Master Kwix. She brought me to the Jedi. Changed my life.
Did you tell Master Kwix about your past?
No. How would I even begin? By the way, I was born a Sith. Is that a problem? I always knew sooner or later I'd have to come clean. Just hoped I could prove myself as a Jedi first. Now the Emperor knows where I am. The Sith will never stop hunting me.
You're my Padawan, Kira. I made a promise to keep you safe.
I know I haven't been a great Padawan, but I'm going to try harder. I'm ready to tell the truth. To Master Kwix, the Jedi Council, everyone. No more secrets. We should probably let the General know he's not getting his Admiral.
The Admiral was never here, General. This was a trap.
Last. I'm sorry for putting you in harm's way on a lie. It won't happen again. I'm afraid there's more bad news. Your Jedi Masters both missed their last two comm checks.
That isn't like Master Kwix. What planet did you send her to?
Tatooine. Master Orgus went to Alderaan. I need you to find out what's happened to them and our weapon labs.
Understood, General. But first, I need to consult with the Jedi Council on an important matter.
More important than saving the galaxy from Darth Angril? I'd like to know what that is.
Sorry, General. Jedi business.
Fine, if that's how you want to play it. Angril's still up there. May the Force be with us all. Barsuthra out.
Let's get this over with. Master Kwix and Orgus need our help. I'll be meditating in my quarters. Let me know when we're at Tython.
Master Satil, my mission has become more complicated. Masters Orgus and Kwix have disappeared. I'm headed for Tatooine and Alderaan to find them. But first, my Padawan has something important to tell you. Kira?
I was born on Dromon Kaas. My parents were Sith. Ooh, much easier the second time. There's more, obviously.
I should hope so. Give me time to assemble the council. Most of us are still off-world.
And then my master convinced me to come here and tell you. That's pretty much everything.
We've heard rumors about these children of the Emperor before, but this finally confirms their existence.
Troubling that we never sensed the truth about Kira when Master Kwix brought her to us.
That makes her especially dangerous. She can't be allowed to remain free.
Kira's master should have a voice in this. What do you recommend?
The situation doesn't require a reaction. I just thought you should know the truth.
And now that we know, We can't ignore the threat she represents to our entire order. To allow her to remain a Padawan, become a Jedi Knight? It's inconceivable.
Is it? Did we not first learn of the children of the Emperor from a Sith turned to the light?
Master Braga speaks the truth. No one is beyond redemption.
It was natural for you to fear our reaction, considering your upbringing. What's important now is that you leave your past behind and devote yourself to the Jedi. Can you do that?
I've been trying to ever since Master Quix found me.
Kira's a good Padawan. I trust her with my life.
There you have it. I need no further proof of Kira's loyalty.
Agreed. And I believe the best course of action is to leave Kira where she is.
This is a mistake. If Master Quix were here, she'd tell you the same.
Until she returns, this council's ruling stands. Kira is safest in your care.
I appreciate you giving her another chance.
I promise I'll make you all proud. Even you, Master Caden.
You did well bringing this to us, but you should return to your mission. May the Force be with you on Tatooine and Alderaan.
Don't think I didn't notice the risk you took by standing up for me. I felt stronger having you there. You're a good master. And a good friend.
We're in this together. I know you'd do the same for me.
I would now. After this, I owe you a few dozen. Ready to go whenever you are, Master.
General, I'm on Tatooine. Has Master Quix reported in?
Last we heard, Quix secured our weapons research facility. She's missed every comm check since then. Enemy action is the most likely scenario, but on Tatooine, anything's possible.
If it's so dangerous, why pick it for your weapons facility?
Tatooine has millions of uninhabited kilometers. Perfect for our research. Dr. Godera will brief you on the weapons project. Doctor?
The research facility on Tatooine has created a device codenamed the Shock Drum. The weapon discharges massive ultrasonic vibrations into the ground. It damages enemy fortifications at a microscopic level, quite literally softening them up. The vibrations will cripple people if they're close enough. But that's not all. The shock drum eventually disrupts the planetary core. At critical mass, the core explodes.
A weapon so destructive has no place in the Republic arsenal.
We only recently discovered its full capabilities. I banned further testing. However, there's a fully operational shock drum prototype at our facility. If Darth Angrel has captured it, the results will be catastrophic. With no word from the facility or Master Quix, we must assume the worst.
I sense Master Quix through the Force, but it's faint. I think she's dying.
Can you feel her surroundings? Where is she?
Not sure. Somewhere dark. It's taking everything she has to stay alive.
I don't have any Republic contacts there to assist you. You're on your own. Our facility is located in a remote part of the desert. I'm transmitting the coordinates. Good luck. Varsuthra, out.
A Jedi? Seabrick, I told you help would come. We'd almost given up hope. Thank you for saving our little family.
Glad to help. Do you people work at this facility?
Have you come to protect the shock drum, like Master Quix?
What happened to her?
She defended us against Imperial soldiers led by a Sith. She fought bravely, but the Sith was stronger.
I take it the Sith killed her then.
I assumed he was going to kill us all. Instead, he captured Master Quix alive and ignored us. The Sith destroyed your droids, but he didn't harm us. He said we were no threat, that we didn't deserve to die.
I've never known a Sith to show mercy.
It was almost like the idea of killing us insulted him.
He wasn't kind, but I certainly wouldn't describe him as cruel. The Sith and his soldiers took Master Kowix and the shock drum prototype into the desert. Brick and I were attempting to restore power to this facility and track them down when the Sand People attacked.
Why would Sand People want a research base?
This facility can pick up the shock drum's locator beacon, but not until we restore power. The Sith knocked out all our generators during his attack. If you reactivate them, we can find him, Master Kowix, and the shock drum. Facility power's back online. I'm afraid that's the only good news I have. I just detected the shock drum's locator beacon. The weapon has been activated. If we don't shut it down, the device will soon reach critical mass. When it does, Tatooine's core will explode.
Why isn't the Sith deploying the shock drum someplace populated, like Coruscant?
Tatooine may not be a core world, but there are still many innocent lives in danger. Pinpointing the shock drum's exact location from here is impossible. The seismic vibrations disrupt our sensors. The general region is thousands of square kilometers. We have to narrow it down somehow. Brick, that's brilliant! The ultrasonic scanners, of course!
If your sensors are useless, what good will scanners be?
Ultrasonic scanners read seismic disruptions in the ground and trace them to their source. Ultrasonic scanners placed in a wide pattern will triangulate the shock drum seismic disturbances. They'll reveal its location. Installing the scanners is extremely dangerous. The desert region is deadly. Ideally, we'd send an army. Your droids won't be ready soon enough, Brick. This Jedi is our only hope.
I feel Master Kowix reaching out to me. Something terrible is happening to her.
At least we know she's still alive.
She doesn't have long.
Take the ultrasonic scanners. Place them at these map coordinates. We'll contact you by holo once we've triangulated the shock drum's location. Good luck.
I place the scanners. Do you have a fix on the shock drum?
Collating the scanner readings now. Ah, no wonder the sensors couldn't find it. It's beneath an abandoned mining complex. I'm sending the coordinates and the shock drum's deactivation code. Everything depends on you now, but we'll be here if you need us.
If I fail, Tatooine gets destroyed. You don't want to be here for that.
All due respect, Master Jedi. If this planet and its people die, I wouldn't be able to live with myself. I hope to see you again. Heron out.
Greetings, Jedi. I am Lord Praven. My master seeks retribution for his son's death. I must give it to him.
If all you want is my death, why destroy Tatooine?
When my master learned you were here, he demanded I activate the shock drum. He'll destroy this entire world. I know you've located the weapon, but that won't be enough. I changed the deactivation code.
Why not let me find out the hard way? What are you after, Lord Praven?
My master deserves justice, but there are more noble ways to have it. I will destroy you personally. Come, face me. If I win, I've done my duty. If you win, you'll have the new code. Whatever the outcome, we will battle with honor. I await you at these coordinates.
I sense your power. Now I understand why Tarnis was no match for you. His death was my failure. I should have trained him better.
The other Sith I fought were full of hatred and arrogance. In you, I sense regret.
My family is true Sith. My only passions are integrity and honor. I welcome the end of your kind. The Jedi obsession with my people's extermination must end. Your lust for revenge will destroy this galaxy.
Whatever you've been told about us, it's a lie. We'd gladly stop fighting if it meant genuine peace.
I'd like to believe that, but I know better. Come. Let us end this. Die well, Jedi. Such skill. So much power. Impressive. You could kill me. Why hesitate?
You could have killed the scientist and those Jawas at the shock drum facility, but you didn't.
They were not warriors. Their deaths would have been pointless. Darth Angrel commanded me to destroy the shock drum code. He wanted you to die in failure, no matter the outcome here. I will not tarnish my honor with petty tricks. You've earned better. The code is yours.
You've done the right thing.
Darth Angrel ordered that Master Kuix suffer greatly before her death. I wish I had disobeyed that order as well.
If Master Kuix is still alive, I will save her.
I left her incapacitated next to your weapon. If they haven't already, the ultrasonic vibrations will eventually tear her apart.
You scum! You should die like that!
There is nothing more to say. You won our duel. Finish me.
You may serve the Empire, but I won't kill you. You don't deserve it.
Then honor demands I surrender to my master. He will do what you cannot.
Look at what your honor and duty has led to. You don't owe that maniac anything.
You could kill me, but refuse. Not out of fear, but compassion. The things I was taught about the Jedi. Were they all lies?
It's never too late to turn from the dark side.
Me? A Jedi? Impossible. Your order would never accept me.
The only way to find out is to ask.
I accept your offer. I'm too wounded to aid you, but I will surrender to your people. Now hurry, save this planet.
The Sith changed the deactivation code for the shock drum, but I have the new one. I'm on my way.
You're not there yet? Brick and his family are in terrible danger. They followed their droids to the mining complex. I tried to stop them, but they were determined to help you. Brick just sent an emergency holo. He says there's something called a sand demon at the mine. It's attacking them.
Some sort of creature?
That beastly predator is the only thing that hunts crate dragons. And those are massive. Brick doesn't stand a chance. Please, you can't let anything happen to Brick and his family. Save them and stop the shock drum. Hurry!
I can't sense Master Kuix at all anymore. I'll handle that beast, my friend. Keep your family safe. Quiet, finally. I can breathe again. I've been down here so long.
Shh, Master, let us help you.
Kira and Orgus's Padawan, you're both changed. What has happened? All that matters right now is you're safe. I only survived this weapon by withdrawing into a deep trance. The Force itself became my armor. Sustaining the trance cost me greatly. My strength is a fraction of what it was.
What you did was miraculous. We'll handle things from here.
I know you faced terrible dangers for me. I will not forget that.
Here you are. I was coming to help when sensors indicated the shock drum stopped,
You did it. Brick wasn't exaggerating about the sand demon. I've never seen anything like it.
Brick was almost a meal for it. Good thing I got here in time.
That's the second time you've saved our little family. Thank you. And let this be a lesson to you, Brick. No more running off pretending to be a hero.
My friends, the danger is not yet past. Even deactivated, that weapon remains a threat. You understand the situation best. What should we do?
This technology can't fall into the wrong hands again. Let's collapse the cavern network with explosives.
What? All that work? The people who died protecting it?
Think how many more would have died. The galaxy is better off without such weapons. I will see to the shock drum. You should return to your ship and inform General Varsuthra what's happened.
Master, you've just been through a terrible ordeal. Will you be all right?
Do not concern yourself with my welfare. I am still a Jedi.
Before we go, you need to know something, and I'd rather you hear it from me. I never told you about my childhood. I'm not who you think I am.
So much about you is now clear to me, Kira. But you're wrong about one thing. You are exactly who I think. A strong, capable young woman. One day, you'll be a great Jedi.
If you could see what she's accomplished, you'd be proud.
We'll meet again on Tython. May the Force be with you.
General, Doctor, good news. Master Quix and Seismologist Heron are safe. Even better, the shock drum was destroyed.
Destroyed? Blast! I wanted to inspect that prototype. Such a promising design.
The only thing it promised was to destroy planets. Honestly, I'm relieved it's gone. I've just received a surprising report from one of my cruisers in the area. A pure-blooded Sith Lord named Praven surrendered to it. He mentioned your name. Anything I should know?
He was one of Darth Angrel's apprentices, but he's joining our side. I promised we wouldn't hurt him.
You keep finding new ways to impress me. I'll order my people to hand the Sith over to the Jedi Council. They'll know what to do. Let's hope your mission to Alderaan goes as well as it did here. Varsuthra out.
General, I'm on Alderaan. Have you heard from Master Orgus?
Negative. Considering the chaos there, it's a wonder any messages get through. Alderaan's a war zone. The nobles are fighting to decide who's in charge, and whether this world aligns with the Republic or the Empire.
I thought Alderaan was already a Republic world.
When we signed the Treaty of Coruscant, hardliners on Alderaan formally withdrew from the Republic. Unfortunately, some nobles took the opportunity to ally with the Empire. My people developed a Deathmark weapon to end this conflict with surgical precision.
Extraordinary device. It marks targets with a microscopic tag. Undetectable. Tracks targets anywhere on the planet. Feed the target's coordinates to a focused beam laser, and it can kill them from across a continent.
Since when is the Republic in the assassination business?
If I can save a billion lives by killing one man, I'll gladly pull the trigger.
The Deathmark has one regrettable disadvantage. The targeting device's range is extremely limited, 20 meters or so. Once a target is marked, however, the laser can hit it from any range.
I fear efforts to guard the weapon have failed. Master Orgus's last transmission came from Organa Palace. After that, nothing.
Could someone in the palace have betrayed Master Orgus?
House Organa is the Republic's strongest ally. Something's happened, but not on their end. Count Alda was the last to see Master Orgus. He co-funds the Deathmark project with us. I tried informing the Count of your arrival, but communications there have been crippled.
Reports indicate multiple holo relays destroyed. Standard Imperial battle tactic.
House Organa can't spare the troops to get their holo relays online. Maybe you can help?
I'll restore communications, and then meet Count Alda.
Transmitting holo relay coordinates. If you get them up and running, it'll tighten House Organa's defenses. You'll find Count Alda at the embassy near Organa Palace. Good luck. Varsuthra out.
Count Alda? I'm an associate of Master Orgus Din. I'm here about the Deathmark project.
Yes, much gratitude for restoring our communications. Elena, tell the Jedi what you told me.
I worked at the Deathmark research facility.
We were conducting routine tests when Imperial forces breached our security doors. There was a hideous little man with them. A Sith, I think.
We sent a Jedi Master to protect your facility. Was he there?
He saved my life. Before anyone knew what happened, a single Jedi wiped out all the Imperial troops.
Way to take care of business, Master Orgus.
I'm sorry, but the Jedi... he didn't survive. The Sith was deadly. He'd vanish, then leap out of the shadows. He surprised your friend, stabbed him in the back. It was horrible.
You're sure Master Orgus was killed?
No one could survive that. When the Jedi fell, the Sith summoned reinforcements. But not Imperials. Killix.
Intelligent, man-sized insects living underground. Flesh-eaters. Ghastly things.
How did the Sith communicate with them?
Oh, they're highly evolved. That's what makes them deadly.
Those things poured into the facility, started tearing everyone apart. I ran.
There was nothing you could have done. Thank the stars you survived to give us this news. The Sith now controls the Death Mark. No telling who he's targeted.
From what I understand, targets can only be marked at close range.
True, but that Sith... I think he could go anywhere he wanted.
Win Organa is organizing peace talks with the other houses. It's possible the Sith...
That was the Death Mark laser! It killed Count Alda!
It happened so fast, I never felt the danger.
Have to get out of here! It's not safe! We're all gonna die!
The Count! You there! Hands up! Men, take their weapons. Lock down this building.
We didn't kill him. We're here to help.
Back against the wall. And put your hands up. This is your final warning.
Are you insane? She's a Jedi Knight. We had nothing to do with this.
We'll verify your identities and alibis. If what you say is true, you'll be released. Long-range communications have been restored. Should only take a few days to sort this out.
There's a Sith trying to destroy Alderaan. I have to stop him.
Please, let the Jedi go. You can arrest me. Will that be enough?
If you are a Jedi, we obviously can't stop you from leaving. I'll release you on your own recognizance. This woman will remain in a secure area until you return.
I appreciate your understanding.
You've got to find the Death Mark before that Sith kills again. Here are the coordinates to the research facility, what's left of it. I hope you find something useful. Take care, Master Jedi.
Hey, what took you so long?
Sorry, Master. All the speeders were taken.
I'll let it go, but only this once.
You've looked better, Master. Sure you're all right?
I've looked worse, Kira. I'll be fine. Blasted Sith almost killed me. It was all I could do to save Dr. Parvix.
The enemy left us here as food for the Killix.
Taking down that Killix leader must have been quite a fight. Thing was huge.
Master, I don't know what you're talking about.
The giant Killix leading these others. You didn't see it? If that thing eats us, you're fired. You all right, Doctor?
Don't worry about me. The Death Mark is in enemy hands. You must warn Count Alda.
The Count was just killed by the Death Mark.
The targeting device was taken to Organa Palace.
Have you met a woman calling herself Elena Hark?
She was with me when Count Alda died. She sent me here.
Must have thought the Killix would get rid of you for her. Elena's a spy. She helped the Sith steal the Death Mark, and now she's targeting people with it.
She could have marked dozens of people by now. The weapon's laser can kill them at any time, anywhere.
Not if we cut its power. The laser's still tied into the local energy grid, right?
Several power stations supply the laser. Deactivating them would take the laser offline, at least temporarily.
Isn't there a central computer controlling the laser? Can't we just shut it down from here?
The Sith took everything with him. We'll have to do this the hard way. I'll get Dr. Parvix to safety. You deactivate the laser's power stations.
I have coordinates to every station. Deactivate them in the order I've described. Don't leave even one functional.
We'll head to the closest Republic-friendly camp. Meet us there. May the Force be with you.
Well, well. The Jedi who killed Tarnas back on Coruscant. I'd rather if you didn't shut down my laser's power stations. I need them. I have so many targets waiting to be vaporized. Who's next? The farm girl or the old colonel?
Point the laser at yourself and put us out of your misery.
Really? That's just rude. Oh dear. I'm afraid the farm girl didn't make it. I wonder how long the old colonel will survive. I can kill anyone I like, and there's nothing you can do about it. Have a lovely day. Determined to spoil my fun, aren't you? Now I have to set up new power stations where you can't reach. At most, you've bought yourself a few hours. Proud of yourself?
We know about your spy. We'll capture Elena and the Death Mark targeting device.
Well, I suggest you hurry. Tick, tick, tick.
I deactivated the laser's power stations, but Darth Angrel's apprentice contacted me. Dozens of innocent people are targets of the Death Mark.
We need to end this before he brings that laser back online. This is Wyn Organa, chief negotiator of the peace talks to end this war.
Elena Hawk had free run of Organa Palace. Everyone there could be a target, including me.
I saw her surrender to the guards when Count Alda was assassinated.
She never made it to her cell. The guards escorting her were found dead. However, my spies report a woman matching her description entered House Thule's compound.
House Thule? They support the Empire.
Yes, but Duke Thule openly advocates the peace process. I thought he was sincere.
What if the Sith want to silence him?
Can we send a message to Duke Thule? Let him know of the danger?
We'd have to use formal diplomatic channels. There's no guarantee he'd receive our warning, much less believe it. If Duke Thule is killed by a Republic secret weapon, the peace process will never recover.
Hate to say it, but our best bet is to storm in there and stop Elena.
Won't violence damage the peace process even worse?
I suspect the Duke will forgive us when we save his life. You're in charge of recovering the Death Mark from House Thule. I have my own mission. There's only a few places Angle's apprentice could be operating from. We need to narrow down that list of candidates.
I'll come with you. Then we'll go to House Thule.
Our destiny's part here, my friend. I'll contact you when I've found our enemy.
I hope to hear from both of you when this threat is ended.
Head for House Thule. May the Force be with you.
Be reasonable, Duke. Your calls for peace are misguided, unnecessary. Lord Nefarid wants what's best for House Thule. Unconditional victory.
And all he asks is that I betray Organa. Who the skies are you?
That woman isn't your ally. She's marking you for death.
Marking me? I don't understand.
It's a trick. Organa sent her to kill you. Be warned, I am prepared to kill you. Lord Nefarid trained me to fight a Jedi.
What about two Jedi?
Guards, defend the Duke.
If you must kill me, at least tell me why.
The Jedi isn't here for you, fool. Not that it matters. No one will escape Lord Nefarid's purge. You're both dead, just like everyone scrabbling for peace. As the last person marked Jedi, you'll be the first to fall.
Lord Nefarid's plans are unraveling. Hand over the targeting device.
If you're hoping to remove that mark on you, don't. I've just rendered the targeting device non-functional.
And we've heard enough from you. Blasted woman has doomed us both. Unless we work together.
You have my full cooperation, Duke.
I knew it would be wise to keep tabs on that Sith. Disgusting little men like him are always up to something. He's using a mountain bunker as a base. I'll give you the coordinates. Kill him if you can.
What defenses should I expect from this base?
The bunker repels torpedo bombers, and that's just the outside. Your work's cut out for you. I'm leaving for the spaceport. I'll try to outrun the death mark in case you fail. But first, this traitor dies.
If you want peace on Alderaan, you must realize death isn't justice.
I'll put her in a detention cell until she can be tried and executed. Go, stop Nefarid, for both our sakes.
Master Orgus, the Deathmark device is destroyed, but I was scanned by it. Darth Angrel's apprentice is targeting me. I'm on my way to his stronghold. Where are you?
Too far to help. I misled you back at the camp. I haven't been searching for the apprentice. I've been hunting Darth Angrel, and I just found his cruiser.
General Varsuthra's been hunting him for days without success.
The general doesn't have the Force as his ally. It called, and I followed. The cruiser's at the edge of the system, outside the reach of planetary sensors. It's about to jump for hyperspace. This may be our only shot at stopping him. I'm boarding that cruiser. Just wanted someone to know. In case.
You're a great Jedi, Master. If anyone can stop Angrel, it's you.
You're the finest student I've ever trained. Wish I'd met you sooner. Stop Angrel's apprentice. Save Alderaan. May the Force be with you. Orgus out.
You truly are a stubborn one. Won't be satisfied until you've completely inconvenienced me, will you?
You're done, Sith. Duke Thule and I captured your spy, and the Death Mark was destroyed.
How disappointing. But I suppose all good times must end. My master is transmitting the most amusing holo message right now. You really should watch it with me.
Assaulting my cruiser alone? Very careless of you, Augustin.
It's not too late, Angrel. Do the right thing for once. Surrender.
Pity you didn't bring your student. I could kill you both. Tell me, Jedi. Are you afraid to die?
There is no death. There is only the Force.
If there is no death, where is my son?
No!
And now I'll finish you. After all, you can't fight what you can't see.
I don't need to see you. I can smell you.
I'm starting to like you. What a shame you have to die. Oh, I almost forgot. The Deathmark laser is finally back online. And it's tracking you.
The Deathmark has been destroyed. Your people are safe.
I will inform Organa Palace immediately. We are forever in your debt. Duke Thule sent us the spy Elena as a show of good faith. She's to stand trial for her crimes. Her testimony will expose the Empire for what it is. No house will ally with them after this.
Darth Angrel captured and murdered my Jedi Master.
My sympathies. Master Orgus seemed like a great man. Rest assured, I won't let your master's sacrifice be in vain. Be well, Jedi.
We should head back to the ship. Tell General Varsuthra about Master Orgus.
General, the Death Mark has been destroyed. And I have news about Master Orgus.
Darth Angrel broadcast Orgus's execution over the holonet. Left the body floating in space for us to find. A Republic shuttle has just recovered the remains from the edge of the Alderaan system. I'm sorry.
Orgus taught me everything I know about being a Jedi.
Darth Angrel has no idea what he's brought on himself.
Your master is dead, but he left us a gift. Somehow, he planted a tracking beacon on Angrel's cruiser without the Sith realizing it. Every time Angle's ship drops out of hyperspace, we know where. Orgus got the last laugh.
What if Angrel finds the beacon Orgus planted?
By the time he realizes we can find him, it'll be too late. We'll make sure of that.
Stand by. Report coming through. Angrel is on the move.
We've just picked up the tracking signal in the Euphrates system. That Agra world supplies nearly half of Carson's food. I'm scrambling the fleet, but you're closer.
My ship isn't equipped to fight a battlecruiser, but I'll think of something.
Any damage to Euphrates' food production could cripple the Republic.
One warship can only destroy so much.
Tell that to Terrace.
Transmitting Euphrates' coordinates. Good hunting.
No sign of Darth Angrel, but Euphrates. I saw this planet once, with Master Kwix. It used to be green. General, I've arrived at Euphrates. There's no sign of Angrel, but the planet... See for yourself.
Receiving your sensor readings. Stand by.
Euphrates' atmosphere looks like it's on fire. What could have done that?
Damage consistent with designs recovered on Ord Mantell. The Desolator weapon.
Angrel's taken the planet prison and turned it into something horrific.
The Desolator borrows technology from all our advanced warfare projects. Angrel's son was quite the genius.
Euphrates had millions of citizens. Whole continents of farmlands. All that life extinguished. The scale of this is... it's unthinkable.
Getting an emergency transmission. It's faint, coming from the far side of the planet.
Republic vessel, do you copy? This is Medical Frigate Daybreaker. We're under attack. Imperial commandos have boarded us. Help!
It's one of ours. The crew may know what happened here.
No more of our people die today. Kira, plot an intercept course.
Already done, Master.
Strap yourselves in. That was the last of the Imperials. You're safe now.
Not a minute too soon. Those commandos weren't taking prisoners.
I still can't believe what happened to Euphrates. When we arrived, an Imperial ship was attacking the planet. I've never seen anything like it.
Euphrates was trapped inside an energy field. Some starships tried to flee, but their engines failed before they could leave the atmosphere.
No one escaped. Every ship that tried crashed back onto the surface.
The enemy made sure there wouldn't be survivors.
We tried to run, but Imperial boarding pods overtook us.
I saw Euphrates' atmosphere catch fire. Horrific destruction. Flames consumed the planet. Everything turned to smoke and ash in seconds.
Could anyone have escaped the destruction?
I don't see how.
Captain, look at this. Our sensors detect faint life readings on the planet's surface. Possible survivors.
Anyone left on that planet is as good as dead.
If we go down there, we can provide food, water, shelter, and medicine. It's our duty.
The energy field surrounding Euphrates will destroy your ship's engines. You won't be able to leave. You could hold out a long time in this ship. Long enough for the Republic to make Euphrates safe again.
We're the only hope those people have. Every second counts. Please, he'll listen to you. Talk to him.
It's not that I don't want to help, but I have a family to think about. This ship carries combat-grade Colto packs, battle adrenals, you name it. Talk her out of this crazy idea. You'll have your pick of our supplies.
I've pinpointed the strongest life signs. We can land immediately.
Render aid to anyone you find. I promise you won't be abandoned down there.
This is insane. I'm taking an escape pod off this lunatic asylum.
My crew can do this without him. Thank you for doing what's right. I'm transmitting our sensor logs of the attack to your ship. Please give them to the Republic High Command. You better go. People on Euphrates need us.
I rescued the Daybreaker, General. I have sensor logs of Engril's attack. However, the crew landed on Euphrates to help possible survivors. They're trapped.
We'll get them back somehow, but Engril is our first priority.
Transmitting sensor logs now.
My initial analysis indicates the Desolator has a similar flaw to the planet prison. The weapon's excessive power requirements demand a lengthy charging period before it can fire.
Small consolation. Engril's next attack will undoubtedly be more direct.
The entire Republic should be warned about this.
Carson needs to begin food rationing immediately. I'll contact the Galactic Senate and put every Republic world on... Wait! We're getting another emergency alert from Typhon. Relaying it now.
Under attack by Darth Engril. Launching defense fighters. Angril's battlecruiser deploying energy weapon. Our ship can't escape Typhon's atmosphere. We're trapped.
That explains why Engril left Euphrates so quickly. He's already chosen his next target.
Engril's going to incinerate Typhon just like he did Euphrates.
And finish what he started years ago. The annihilation of the Jedi. The Republic fleet's in hyperspace. By the time it's redirected to Typhon, it'll be too late.
The Desolator needs time to work. The Jedi may be trapped on Typhon, but you're not. You could board Engril's battlecruiser, disable the weapon before it fires.
There are other Jedi not on Typhon. Send them to help me.
I'll gather all the reinforcements I can find, but it'll take time.
I'll use the sensor logs to find the Desolator's weak point. Contact us when you're aboard Engril's warship.
May the Force be with you.
General, we got a little scorched, but we're inside Engril's battlecruiser.
Yes, I knew you could do it. Now to end that Sith for good.
Won't be that simple. The sensor logs of Engril's warship reveal he's amplified the vessel's reactors. That's a little trick he learned from me when I was interrogated by his spy on Taris. Blast his truth serums and mind probes. Disarming the Desolator weapon will necessitate overloading at least 3 shielded reactor relays. No simple task.
General? Doctor? My team's moving out. We'll save Typhon or die trying.
Don't even think that. I expect us all to reach a ripe old age. Your signal's breaking up. May the...
Engril's jamming our transmissions. He's coming for us. Thanks for the vote of confidence, T7. Be careful out there.
You will not steal my victory. Not now. I have sacrificed too much for this. I will avenge my son on you and all the Jedi.
Sacrifice? Is that what you call your genocide on Euphrates?
This was merely a test and a lure to bring you here. I foresaw this confrontation. I welcome it. Today I forge a new era for the Sith. One where the Jedi are finally extinct.
Finish this, Engril. I command it.
With pleasure, my master.
What was that? I felt the Emperor.
You are his child. His eyes, his ears, his weapon to command. Come, child, fight by my side. It's where you belong.
I'd rather jump out an airlock naked. Fight the Emperor's control. Remember who you are. I feel him in my thoughts. We have to end this fast.
If you will not serve, you will die. For Tarnis.
Angrel's dead, and this battle cruiser's not far behind him.
Disappointing. Angrel was useful. This child must learn her place. And so will you.
Leave Kira alone. If you want to fight, face me in person.
That is unnecessary. I see futures in you. Futures I will not allow. Your future ends here. This child is unfinished, weak. I will make her strong. Now you will die. Even if my child must die with you.
No, I won't kill for you. You're resisting him. Keep it up. The dark side has no power over me. I am a Jedi. He's gone. I won. I'm finally free. Your life is your own, Kira. And I have you to thank, Master. The ship's coming down on top of us. Let's get out of here.
Thank the Force you're alive. When I saw Angrel's battlecruiser explode, I feared the worst.
Good to see you, Master Satil. Everyone safe down there?
We are now, thanks to you. Please come to the surface. Bring your Padawan to the Council Chambers. We all have much to discuss.
Welcome home. The Jedi owe you a debt of gratitude we can never repay.
If Jedi wore Republic medals, your robe would be covered in them.
Only wish Master Orgus could share in this victory.
You're looking well, Master Quix.
Better with each passing day, thanks to you.
We've lost one of our noblest masters. But in his place stands a Jedi without equal. And you, Padawan. I knew you'd remain true to us.
I see no reason why we shouldn't make Kira a full-fledged Jedi Knight.
I agree. My troubled former Padawan has matured into a fine Jedi.
As leader of this council, it's my pleasure to promote Kira Carson to the rank of Jedi Knight.
You mean it? It seems only fair. You did help save the galaxy.
So this is what it feels like, being respectable.
The danger to Tython is over. We're getting fresh reports of hostilities all over the galaxy. Another war with the Empire seems inevitable.
Darth Angrel was the spark that lit the flame. Even in failure, he inspired the Sith to violence.
But he also forged our greatest weapon against the darkness. The Force has shown me what lies ahead. The futures of many rest on your actions. You will decide the fate of the Jedi, the Republic, the galaxy.
Master, that's quite a burden. I'm only one Jedi.
The will of the Force can't be denied. But I'll stand by you through everything we must face. May the Force be with you. With all of us.